This video will explore the uniform polyhedra, the polyhedra with regular faces and identical vertices. The first complete list of uniform polyhedra was published in 1954 by the legendary geometer Donald Coxeter, along with M.S. Longuet-Higgins and J.C.P. Miller. They had in fact all been discovered by 1932, over 20 years earlier, but publication had been postponed in the hope of finding a proof that the list was complete. The first proof of completeness came in 1970 by Soviet mathematician S.P. Sopov. As far as I can tell, this paper remained unknown in the West for many years. Cambridge mathematician John Skilling published an independent proof in 1975 without mention of Sopov. Apart from the prisms and antiprisms, there are 75 uniform polyhedra. In previous videos, I've covered the 5 Platonic solids, 13 Archimedean solids, and 4 Kepler-Poinsot polyhedra. But this still leaves 53 polyhedra, the non-convex equivalents of the Archimedean solids, to be discussed. We'll start with the 11 polyhedra with tetrahedral or octahedral symmetry. If you look at a wireframe octahedron, you can see that the framework can be filled with squares through the centre. If 4 of the octahedron's faces are restored, it forms a uniform polyhedron, a tetrahemihexahedron. This is an unusual figure in many ways. It has 7 faces, the only uniform polyhedron with an odd number of faces, apart from some prisms. Some faces pass through the centre. This is what the hemi in its name means. It's the only concave uniform polyhedron with tetrahedral symmetry. Finally, it has only one surface, like a Möbius strip. Its Euler characteristic is 1, unique among uniform polyhedra. More hemipolyhedra can be generated from the cube octahedron. 4 hexagons can be fitted through the centre. If the original triangles are restored, it creates the octahemioctahedron. Alternatively, the hexagons plus the original squares create the cubohemioctahedron. These hemipolyhedra have an undefined density, and a dual cannot be constructed in the normal way. A more complicated figure can be created from the truncated cuboctahedron. If we stretch the hexagons outwards while holding their centres in place, the other faces are initially distorted, but the squares eventually become squares again, the octagons turn into octagrams, and we get the great truncated cuboctahedron. The original paper by Coxeter et al. Didn't provide names. Most of the names in common use were given by Norman Johnson of Johnson Solids fame. We didn't add or remove any faces, vertices or edges in this process, so this polyhedron is topologically the same as the cuboctahedron, despite its very different appearance. Viewing the different face types separately might help understand the structure of this polyhedron. If you take a rhombicube octahedron and remove the faces, leaving a wireframe model of just the edges, you can reuse the same edges by fitting it with 6 intersecting octagons. A complete polyhedron can then be made by restoring the original triangles and 6 of the squares. This is the small cubicube octahedron. Alternatively, the octagons and the other 12 squares can be fitted together to form the small rhombihexahedron. One other figure can be constructed from the rhombicube octahedron. If you move all the triangles inwards, through the centre and out the other side, you get a shape called the non-convex great rhombicube octahedron. In the same way as the previous figure, this is topologically identical to the rhombicube octahedron. Again, separating the different face types gives a clearer idea of how it fits together. We can do a similar trick with the truncated cube. Pushing the triangles through the centre makes a stellated, truncated hexahedron. Again, appearance notwithstanding, the two are structurally very similar. The faces all pass close to the centre, giving it a density of 7. Two more polyhedra can be made by joining the vertices of the truncated cube with 6 octagrams. Adding further squares and triangles gives the great cubicube octahedron. Alternatively, squares only can be added diagonally to make the great rhombohexahedron. The final uniform polyhedron with octahedral symmetry is the cubic truncated cube octahedron. This is a relatively simple structure with the same hexagons and octagons as the truncated cube octahedron, but with octagrams instead of squares as the truncating faces. That's all for this video. In part 2, I'll start covering some of the more complicated shapes with icosahedral symmetry. See you then.